Good day, viewers, and welcome to the Polymer Update Daily News Show. This is Preksha Potra from the Polymer Update Mumbai office. Today's special newsreel is sponsored by Mumbai-based S. Amit Specialty Chemicals Private Limited, a leading full-service chemistry solutions provider in India, delivering products and services in the areas of specialty chemicals, intermediates, and performance chemicals. The company invites all to visit their booth number H3C11, hall number 3, at Plast India 2018, to be held at Gandhinagar, Ahmedabad, Gujarat from February 7th to 12th, 2018. In important news, state-owned Oil and Natural Gas Corporation has received an approval from the government for selling its stake in IOCL NGAIL to help funding of ₹36,915 crore acquisition of Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited. In polypropylene market update, this week the purchase pulse continued to remain strong in China and Southeast Asia. Owing to firm buying sentiments and higher upstream costs, PP prices in Far East Asia and Southeast Asia are likely to rise by $10 to $20 per metric ton today. In polyethylene market update, in the Far East and Southeast Asian markets, demand and pricing trends continue to remain firm in PE on the back of high upstream costs, strong import offers from the overseas producers, and improved buying interest in the region. HDPE and LDPE prices may rise by $10 to $20 per metric ton in the Far East and Southeast Asian region. LLDPE prices are also expected to increase in the Far East and Southeast Asian region by $5 to $10 per metric ton. In polyvinyl market update, in China and Southeast Asia, buying trends remain steady in the PVC markets, with strong import offers from overseas supplier. High upstream crude and ethylene prices coupled with firm EDC and VCM costs have supported the bullish price undertone. VCM plant shutdown in Indonesia and plant turnarounds in Japan have further contributed to the firm regional PVC rates. Although prices will climb, midweek prices of PVC in China are likely to quote steady, while in Southeast Asia, prices of PVC may rise by $10 per metric ton. In India, a South Korean producer has concluded deals for PVC resin suspension grade at $990 per metric ton for shipment in February 2018 on a CIF Nawasheva port basis. In domestic market updates, most market players are of the opinion that HDPE prices are expected to increase by local producers today by 1 rupee per kg basic, while LDPE and PVC prices are likely to rise by 1 rupee to 1 rupee 50 paisa per kg basic. LLDPE and PP prices, according to most, would be left unchanged. India's first post-GST union budget is going to be presented by Finance Minister Arun Jaitley on 1st Feb 2018. While the country anxiously awaits the last budget by the ruling government before the 2019 election, Polymer Update spoke with a few eminent industry experts to get an insight into their expectations from the budget. Let's see what they have to say.
Well, reduction in taxes is most welcome, but I would like to see more of the implementation of the GST is really bureaucratic, and we need to find ways and means to reduce the paperwork and number of returns and number of papers that have to be filed, you know, time and again. So ease of using GST is more important than the taxes right now. I think the corporate taxes in India are not that high compared to what it is in USA and in Europe. Yes, it is higher than the developing countries around us, but still I think the growth is not related to the corporate taxes, is more related to the other, you know, like GST being bureaucratic and certain one window investment which has been declared but it's still not being implemented properly. It's being implemented in some states like Gujarat, in Uttarakhand, but in other states there's still a lot of procedures required. So people who want to invest in India are looking at simplification rather than reduction in corporate taxes, because the people who will invest are actually from developed countries like USA, Europe, where the tax, corporate tax is very high. So they like the tax structure in India. Actually, they are not looking at any reduction in corporate taxes. For the common people, they are doing a lot right now by reducing GST or even making it 0% in a lot of commodities that is required for the poor people or the middle income class. What they need to do is put an impetus on infrastructure, because infrastructure is something which is really lagging behind. We build roads which in 5 years are not even adequate enough to cater to the traffic and the growth in the population. So looking ahead and doing something better is more important before the next elections. My personal opinion is that there's not a lot of plastic scraps being exported from India. In fact, we ourselves use a lot of scrap internally, and I think more important would be allowing India to import scraps so that, you know, it can grow the plastic industry a lot. We have a lot of innovations in reusing plastic scraps in a proper manner. Some of them have also created fuel out of plastic scraps. We are going to have a demonstration at Plast India in the recycling pavilion. And looking at that, I think whatever scrap is generated within India, we will be able to use it ourselves. As you know, now the import policy has been simplified a lot. And we think with the same policy and reducing the basic customs duty would really help in the export of plastic products from India. The reduction in the basic customs duty would be a welcome step. We will get a lot of capital equipment at cheaper price. So technology will come into India. We will make good products, good finished products that will help our exports. So I think the government should be looking at reduction in imports duties in this current budget.
If you've enjoyed watching this daily news video from Polymer Update and have found it to be useful for your business, please subscribe to our channel by pressing the button below. It's Wednesday, January 24th. This is Preksha. Thank you. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/polymerupdate and be sure to click the like button. You may also find us on Twitter @polymerupdate. For the latest news from the plastics and petrochemicals industry, subscribe to our YouTube channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon.